वेलकम स्टूडेंट, माय नेम इज़ मिराज अहमद। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टुडे टॉपिक एक्चुअल वेपर कंप्रेशन साइकिल एंड सम अदर रेफ्रिजरेशन साइकिल। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी ऑलरेडी टॉक अबाउट द आइडियल साइकिल ऑफ आइडियल वेपर कंप्रेशन साइकिल। यू कैन ऑल्सो से दैट द सिंपल वीसी साइकिल, बट देयर सम डिफरेंस बिटवीन द आइडियल साइकिल्स एंड द एक्चुअल वेपर साइकिल। In the ideal cycle, we cannot assume the irreversibility like friction and the pressure drop in the walls and something like that. But in the actual cycle, we consider all the losses and the friction and the irreversibility in the device and the pipeline. So the cycle is the actual cycle. The cycle considers so far the internally irreversible and no change of refrigerant state take place in the connecting pipeline, which is the idle cycles. However, in actual VCR system, several irreversibility exists. Like that, the pressure drop in evaporator, there are always pressure drop in the evaporator. But in the idle cycle, we cannot say that the pressure drop in the evaporator. But in the actual cycle, there are some pressure drop in the evaporator, in the condenser, and the some heat exchanger, liquid suction heat exchanger. So the second one is the pressure drop according to the suction and discharge valve of compressor, because in the discharge valve there is throttle portion is there. So here the some pressure drop should be there in the inlet and outlet valve of the compressor. Then the heat transfer in the compressor. So, in the compressor, in the real, it should be polytropic process. So the heat should be transferred into the compressor, and the heat can be come out from the compressor. So there is some irreversibility in the heat transfer in the compressor. And the fourth one is the pressure drop and heat transfer in the connecting pipeline. So the evaporator is connected with the compressor from the pipeline. In that pipeline, there is some pressure drop and some heat should be enter into the pipeline, and the heat should be transferred from the pipeline to the atmosphere. So this type of irreversibility should be there in actual vapor cycle. So now we are going to consider this irreversibility and then see the TDS diagram, how this irreversibility to implement can be draw in the actual vapor cycle. So now we are going to, this is a PS diagram of actual vapor compression cycle. Now we start from the 1D. 1D is a saturated vapor, and this is saturated vapor line. So in a simple, in the ideal cycle, we know that the vapor refrigerant should be entered into at this point only, at this point in the compressor. But in the actual cycle, there is some losses are there like that, okay. But in the ideal cycle, we can enter the refrigerant, vapor refrigerant, in at that point. But in the actual cycle, we require some superheated should be required, because at this point we cannot say that the all refrigerant, all liquid refrigerant will be converted into the vapor state. So it is desirable to superheat little bit superheated of refrigerant, so all liquid should be converted into the vapor state. Now we can start from here and see that what the actual cycle is of vapor compression cycle is there. So at point 1D is a saturated vapor, and from point 1D to 1C there is superheated in evaporator, okay. This is slightly superheated to confirm that the all liquids of refrigerant should be converted into the vapor state. So then after that, at point 1 to 1B, there is a pressure drop and there is a superheated of vapor in suction line, सुपर हीटेड इन ए सक्शन लाइन बिकॉज इन द पाइप लाइन्स द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द दिस रेफ्रिजरेंट इन द पाइप लाइन शुड बी लो सो हीट शुड बी कम फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग इन टू द पाइप सो द द टेम्परेचर ऑफ दिस रेफरेंस शुड बी इंक्रीज एंड इट शुड बी मोर हीटेड सुपर हीटेड आफ्टर दैट एट पॉइंट वन बी देन फ्रॉम पॉइंट वन बी टू वन ए देर इज ए प्रेशर ड्रॉप टू द इन इनलेट टू द कंप्रेसर वेयर द इनलेट वॉल्व सो फ्रॉम पॉइंट वन बी टू वन ए इज सक्शन लाइन प्रेशर ड्रॉप सॉरी द वन फ्रॉम पॉइंट वन बी टू वन ए देर इज ए प्रेशर ड्रॉप इन ए सक्शन लाइन सो पॉइंट वन ए टू पॉइंट ए इज ए प्रेशर ड्रॉप अक्रॉस द सक्शन वॉल्व और इनलेट वॉल्व ऑफ द कंप्रेसर हियर द थ्रॉटलिंग प्रोसेस वुड बी देयर इन द इनलेट वॉल्व सो द दिस इज प्रेशर ड्रॉप इन इन द इनलेट वॉल्व ऑफ द कंप्रेसर आफ्टर दैट फ्रॉम पॉइंट वन टू टू देर इज ए पॉलीट्रॉपिक प्रोसेस पॉलीट्रॉपिक कंप्रेशन शुड बी देयर इन ए कंप्रेसर सो आफ्टर दैट पॉइंट टू 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 ए देर इज ए प्रेशर ड्रॉप देर इज ए प्रेशर ड्रॉप अक्रॉस द डिस्चार्ज वॉल्व ऑफ द कंप्रेसर विच इज अंडर द थ्रॉटलिंग प्रोसेस देन आफ्टर दैट टू ए टू टू बी देर इज ए प्रेशर ड्रॉप इन ए डिलीवरी लाइन पाइप लाइन आर देयर टू कनेक्ट विद द कंडेंसर सो देर इज ए प्रेशर ड्रॉप इन द डिलीवरी लाइन From point 2B to 2C, so this is a high temperature, this reference should be high temperature, so the temperature of surrounding should be low, so some heat should be flow out from the pipe to the surrounding, so there should be T superheating of vapor in a delivery pipe. Then from point 2C to From point 2C to 3 is a constant pressure heat rejection in the condenser. So from point 2C to 3 is a constant pressure heat rejection process will be there in a condenser valve. There also is some pressure drop also there in that. So the point 2C to 3 there is a constant pressure heat rejection in the condenser then after that the point 3 to 3A there is a subcooling in the condenser so the vapor should become subcooled to point 3A then after that from point 3A to 3B there is a subcooling of refrigerant So the heat should be added into the pipe. So the temperature of this subcooling should be increased. From point 3B to 4, there should be an expansion in the expansion device. Then we get the point 4. After that point 4 to point 1D, there is a pressure drop in evaporator. Now come to the TDS diagram. You can see the same. You can hear from point 1D to 1C there is a superheated. From point 1C to 1B there is a superheating in suction because the temperature of in the vapor in the pipe should be low from the surrounding. So the heat should be transferred from the surrounding to the pipe. So there should be some superheated should be there. After that point A, B, so the temperature should be increased. After point A, B to point A, A, 1A, so there is a pressure drop. So the pressure drop is there, so the temperature should be decreased. So here, point A to, 1A to point A, there is a pressure drop in the inlet of inlet valve of the compressor. After that, this one from point 1 A2 to there is a polytropic compression should be there. So then after that, point 2 to 2A should be pressure drop in a outlet of the compressor or outlet valve of the compressor. So the pressure drop should be there as a small decrease in the temperature also in the in this process. Then after that, from point 2A to 2B, the pressure drop in delivery line. Then the point 2B to 2C, there is a de-superheating of vapor in a delivery line. Then point 2C to 3 is a constant pressure heat rejection in the condenser. Then point 3 to 3A, this is a subcooling should be there in the condenser. After that, the liquid should be in the low temperature, so the small some heat should be enter into on the surrounding into the pipe. So this with some temperature should be increased from 3A to 3B. After that, the 3B, the liquid subcool liquid should be enter into the expansion device through the throttling process from 3B to 4. After that, the 4, the mixture of the liquid and vapor should be entered into the evaporator to extract the heat from the storage space. So there is also some pressure drop in from point 4 to 1D. So we can see that there is a huge pressure drop in the evaporator only. There is small pressure drop in a condenser. So there is a huge pressure drop in the evaporator. If it is should confirm that the refrigerant effect for the actual cycle is should be less. So the COP should be less for actual vapor compressor cycle. The most important point should be you can see that the pressure drop in the evaporator and the condenser, there are two types of pressure drop in the evaporator and the condenser. One is a friction pressure drop and another is a momentum pressure drop. In the evaporator, the friction drop should be a negative because the liquid, the vapors should be have a friction with the pipe with the wall of the evaporators. So the friction pressure should be negative in the evaporator, and the momentum pressure drops in the evaporator should be also negative. So these two negatives should be added up and the huge pressure drop should be there in the evaporator. But in the condenser, the friction pressure drop should be in negative, but the momentum pressure drop should be in positive. So this should be a subtracted, so the pressure drop should be low in the condenser. So one more important point also, you can see that from the point 1 to A, you can see that the entropy at point 1 should be increased. After some points, the entropy should be decreased. So how this is possible? When the vapor enter into the compressor, it should be have at a very less temperature. So some amount of heat should be enter into the compressor to increase the entropy at the starting of the compressor. But after that, some compression should be done by the compressor. So that vapor should be heated up, should be goes up to a higher temperature. So from that higher temperature, the heat from the from the compressor to be transferred from the surrounding. So there is some drop in the entropy. So what the factors should be affected? Parameter, performance parameter according to the actual vapor compressor cycle. The performance from the performance point of view, the pressure drop in the evaporator in the suction line and across the suction valve has a significant on the performance. So we also say about that the pressure drop in the evaporator should be very high as compared to the compressor. So the refrigerant effect for the actual vapor compressor cycle should be less. So the COPE of the system should be decreased. Due to this reason, the suction side pressure drop increase and the specific volume at the suction, the compressor and discharge temperature very high. So when the outlet of the evaporator, the pressure drop should be there. So the compressor has to work more and deliver the high temperature vapor. So there is a work input should be high. All these effects lead to reduction in the system capacity and increase in the power input. Now also affecting the life of the compressor due to the high discharge temperature. So the compressor life should be decreased because the height it can discharge the high discharge vapor at high temperature. So hence this pressure drop should be small as possible for the good performance. So the pressure drop should be small. So to increase the performance of the system, so proper lubrication and some should be there, and then proper material selection will be very important for this point of view. The irreversibility between the in the compressor, you can see that the idle cycle is 1, 2s, 3, and 4. This is the idle cycle. But you can also know that in compressor there is a polytropic process there, and this bold line should be the isentropic process there. So for the same refrigerant effect, the COPE should be lower for the actual cycle because work input should be high for the actual cycle. So how can you write the efficiency of isentropic compression? So isentropic compression efficiency is the ratio of the minimum heat, so minimum theoretical work input to the actual work input. It means that suppose it is isentropic compression efficiency means that it is a reversible process. So the compressor is a consuming device, so we cannot, when we not consider the friction, so if we consume less amount of energy. So if it is reversible process there in the compressor, so it can consume more input energy. So here the friction should be not there. From 1 to 2s the friction should be zero, so it consume less energy. But in actual process, this is a polytropic process, so the friction should be there, so it consume more energy power work input. So the efficiency, the ratio of the theoretical to the actual work input. So the actual work input is 2 H1. This is work input of the compressor, H2 minus H1, and the work input of the idle cycle for the isentropic process S2S minus H1. Put the value in efficiency, you can get that S2S minus H1 is a isentropic process. This should be higher. So the efficiency should be coming to below the 1. So the high and the lower should be in the denominator and the higher should be in the numerator. Now come to some other refrigerant cycle, the cascade refrigerant system. When we require to maintain moderate low temperature, so then the corresponding evaporator pressure should be also low. So suppose we require to maintain the very low moderate temperature, so the evaporator pressure should also very low, the evaporator pressure also very low, and this result higher pressure ratio. The pressure is, suppose we have to maintain lower pressure at 0.1, okay, the T1 temperature. So the evaporator pressure should also very low. So the pressure ratio should be increased. The pressure, the high, and this result in the high pressure ratio, due to this higher the volumetric efficiency will be reduced. So you can see that to avoid this condition, we can use two VC cycle in a series to avoid these two more vapor compression cycle in a series is called the Cascade system. So we are using this two VC cycle are there, and which is connected with the heat exchanger. And this heat exchanger is considered as the condenser for the first VC cycle, and this is heat exchanger should be considered as the evaporator for the second cycle. So first, from point at 1, the vapor state can be compressed into the first compressor from 1 to 2. After that, the constant heat rejection process should be there from 2 to 3. Here between the heat exchange should be heat exchanger should be there, so heat can be exchanged between this condenser and the evaporator. And then after that, this is compressed from 5 to 6. After that, the compressor, then after that, the expansion valve is moved like that. Okay, you can see that this huge amount of work input should be less for Cascade system, and the refrigerant effect should also be increased. So because of that, the heat exchange, the heat exchanger should be used between those two cycles. So for the same system, the work input should be less and the refrigerant effect should be increased, so the COP of the whole system should be increased. The other one is a multi-stage compression refrigeration system. Here it's just like a Cascade system, but in place of the heat exchanger, we using the flash chamber. The working of the flash chamber is only that the vapor should be filtered from the water and should be enter into this line. Suppose the vapor should be entered into two, from at point 1 to the compressor, to the single first compressor, then the vapor should be come out at point 2, and this is a mixing valve. This vapor which is coming from the flash chamber, and this vapor can be mixed in the mixing chamber, then move to the next VC cycle. And this is a TS diagram. The need of this flash chamber is only for the same capacity, the evaporator side should be less, because the vapor should be less amount of refrigerant should be handled by this evaporator. So because the vapor of the refrigerant should be separated from flash chamber and enter into the mixing chamber. So multi-stage compressor system is which is only for that, to reduce the size of the evaporator. Now come to the use of the heat exchanger in the vapor compression cycle. Already see that in a simple vapor compression cycle, inlet to the compressor should be the reference should be in a vapor state, but from the help of the heat exchanger, the heat exchanger should be placed between इनलेट टू द कंप्रेसर एंड आउटलेट टू द कंडेंसर. तो हीट एक्सचेंज बिटवीन दिस टू देयर, सो दे द हीट विच हीट ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम द कंडेंस आउटलेट ऑफ द कंडेंसर टू द हीट टू द वेपर एट द इनलेट टू द कंप्रेसर. सो इट शुड बी स्लाइटली हीटेड, सुपर हीटेड. देन आफ्टर दैट दिस इज ए फ्रॉम 1-2 इज ए कंप्रेसर इन द विच इज एजेंट्रोपिक प्रोसेस. आफ्टर दैट 2-3 दिस इज ए हीट रिजेक्शन प्रोसेस इन द कंडेंसर. सो सब कूलिंग फ्रॉम 3-3 डैस. आफ्टर द सब कूल लिक्विड शुड बी एक्सपेंडेड इन द एक्सपेंशन वॉल एंड दिस. After that, at point four, the liquid mixture, vapor mixture should be entered into the evaporator and the heat extracted from the storage space. So here the soap cooling should be there. So the refrigerant effect should be increased for this system. So, but the power input should be same. So the COP of the system should be increased. So, using heat exchanger, the COP of the system should be increased. So, for the heat exchanger, heat loss is equal to heat gain. This is the heat loss by the condenser after outlet of the condenser, and this is heat gain by the refrigerant after outlet of the evaporator. And this is the COP of this system. So, Using of heat exchanger to improve the performance of the Vc cycle, which increase the COP of the system. Now come to the some merits and demerits of the vapor compressor system. Vc cycle system, high COP, we get high COP as very close to the Carnot cycle, and the running cost of VC system is 1/5 of the air refrigerant cycle. Size of the evaporator is very small for the same refrigerant effects. Evaporator temperature adjustment is simple, just by thermocouples, thermometer, by adjusting the throttle valve. Some demerits are there. Initial cost is very high, inflammability, leakage should be there, and the toxicity. The refrigerant should be toxic, so the selection of the refrigerant should be very, very. Thank you. This is today for today lecture. In the next lecture, we discuss about some numerical problem regarding the VC cycle.